Unfortunately, when modeling, encountering some shading issues and things like that is a common occurrence. So today, I'm going to be teaching you the most important thing to prevent these shading issues from happening, and that's understanding normals. So first of all, I'm going to press Shift A, and then under Mesh, I'm going to add a cube. Then I'm going to press Tab to go into Edit Mode. Right now, you can see we've got a nice cube, and a normal is essentially the direction that each of these faces have. Vertices can also have a norm, which can be important to fix sometimes, but for today, we're just going to focus on the normals of the faces. Right now though, we can't see the direction of our face's normals, so we need to enable that. To do that, I'm going to come up to this symbol, which looks like two circles, called Show Overlays. Then there's an arrow beside it, and when I left click it, you can see there's more things here which I can enable to display. You can see this menu allows you to remove things, such as these axes for example, or the floor. I'm going to turn them back on by left clicking them. But here, we're looking for this thing called Face Orientation. Right now, you can see everything has been turned blue. This blueness is not caused by a material, but rather it's showing us what way our faces are facing. So right now, the blue means that these faces are facing outside, which is correct and what we're looking for. If your faces are facing the wrong way, they will be red. To demonstrate this, I'm going to zoom in to my object until eventually I go inside it. Now I'm inside the object, you can see the faces inside are red, as they should be, since this is the inside of the face, and the inside of the face should be red. But why is this important? Well, if all these faces were red, it would be likely to cause some shading issues inside a Blender. But the problem stretches even outside a Blender. For example, when you take it into some game engines display the inside of a face as transparent. So you might end up with a completely invisible object if all your faces were inside out. But as long as your faces are blue like this, you should be all good to go in terms of normals. But that begs the question, how do these normals even get messed up in the first place? Sometimes it can happen while you're editing your object. It's kind of hard to demonstrate because it's sometimes hard to know what exactly causes it, but pretty much the only way you'll be able to know is if your face is turned red. So what I've done is, just for the sake of example, I've quickly changed the normal of one of these faces off camera just to show you how we can fix it. Since we only have one face here that's affected, it's actually very easy. All I need to do is left click this face here, then I can left click this mesh option, and here we have a normals menu. And here you can see we've got a few options, some of them with some hotkeys. So I can choose this flip button, and that's just going to alter it. But there's actually a much easier way we can do this using the hotkeys. I've messed up a couple more faces again, and this time we just want to recalculate everything so it's facing outside. And to do that, we can just recalculate the normals as a whole. So if you remember, we can press A to select all, and then what I'm going to do is press Shift N, and that's going to recalculate the normals, which means the ones that are outside will be made outside. And this can be great if you have an object with a lot of faces and you need to make sure that all of your faces are facing outside. You can see a little menu will appear, and I can left click to open this, and if for whatever reason you wanted to make it inside out, you could just left click this inside button, and now everything which is calculated as outside will now be inside in terms of face normal orientation. Something else you can do, rather than going and trying to find the flip command, you can press Ctrl Shift N to flip it in the inside automatically without having to check the box. But this is quite a rare case. I'll press Ctrl Z to undo that. And last thing I'm going to show you is another way we can show our normals. And this is only accessible in edit mode. So I'll come up here and make sure that I'm in edit mode. And here, there's a button here called Mesh Edit Mode. And if I left click it, you can see I've got a few more options. And here, under Normals, you can see we can show some different types of normals. For example, the vertex normals, which I'll talk about in a later video. And we've also got face normals, which will allow us to see the direction of our faces. You can see that these lines are pointing outward, showcasing how they're facing the right way. You can notice if I choose A and then Control Shift N and reset everything, you can see we can't see the lines anymore because they're now pointing inside. So these blue lines are another way to tell if your normals are facing the right way. If you want to make them bigger, you can change the size of them here in this menu. When I press Tab to go back into object mode, you can see that we can no longer see those lines. So it is an edit mode only feature. But yeah, that just about covers the basics of normals in Blender and why they're important to know about when you're modeling. This video is part of an ongoing series I'm making on learning 3D modeling in Blender for absolute beginners. So if you want to follow along with this series, make sure to check out the playlist here, which is having videos added to it daily at the moment. Or if you're watching this video at a later date, maybe all the videos have already been uploaded. So if you enjoy my style of teaching, please feel free to check that out. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.